What's going on, guys? Wade here. I am so excited. I'm at really the most famous granite quarry in the entire world, Rock of Ages in Barre, Vermont. This is really the highest quality granite in the entire world, right here in the US. Historic quarry that's been operating for a very long time and has a really rich history with craftsmen that are here. I'm in front of the visitor center right now. We're going to go on a tour of the quarry itself that's active and operating, where there's workers up on the face of the stone. And then behind me, there's a building. I'm sure they call it the production facility or something along those lines. But this production facility here is where they do all of their finishing work on their headstones and monuments, art pieces. So they have master craftsmen that have been working here, many generations of craftsmen. So you think about the trades that are passed down from one generation to the next inside of a family. That's exactly what you're seeing here. You've got individuals that are hand carving amazing detail into stones, human-like faces, decorative components, really an amazing piece of work, massive facility, massive quarry, but also just the finest example of craftsmanship and quality of stone. So it's really a 1-2 punch with that. Very excited to be here and stay tuned.
After Rock of Ages formed a corporation, they started buying all the other outlying quarries. And in 1986, they bought the last outlying quarry, which was the Wells Lamson's quarry. We are now the world's largest mining and manufacturing of marble and granite. I want to tell you about me. And I tell people, I don't call this brag, I call it fact. The fact that I came to work in the quarries in 1970. I worked here for 35 years. I retired in 2005. And 5 years ago, I came back. I came back and see the director and asked him if I could be a tour guide. And he said, you know what, Roger? We have never had a quarry worker be a tour guide. Let's see how you do. That was 5 years ago. I'm still here. I like talking about the quarries. I like talking about the granite because that's what I did most half of my life. Before I take you to the top of the quarry, I want to talk about what you can do while you're here. We have a bowling lane here. That bowling lane's out in front of the manufacturing plant. Now, that bowling lane was built in 1958 for the Brunswick people, the bowling ball people. They thought that they could use our granite aboard cruise ships. But they found out that if they take their bowling ball and roll it down on our granite would break their balls. Our balls are rubber, the pins are plastic, and there's a couple of signs that'll take you to the bowling lane that's out there. Now, so if you want to try the game, this is the way I tell them it's done. We have no ball return, we have no pin setter. We have the lane, we have the balls, we have the pin. So if you take and roll that ball down that pin, down that lane, that ball does not come back, you have to chase it. If you knock those pins over, you have to reset them. So you go have fun, enjoy it, but be very careful about falling and slipping. Man, it doesn't give it all.
Something that I'm curious about, you've got an active quarry. When was it the original individuals that founded this? Was this 100 some years ago?
Oh yeah. It was founded, well, actually, the quarry was started before Rock of Ages was founded.
Okay.
It was called the three men that...
Somebody
that,
else was operating.
Yeah, Varnum. Yeah. Varnum and Milne and Botwell.
Well, so I guess what else...
That was the name of the quarry.
Okay.
And then when they become a corporation, they just said, hey, we're going to call it Rock of Ages.
Sure. I was curious about the different types of granite in terms of the color that come out of this quarry.
And no. We only have one
you
color.
You just have one. Okay, yeah. Are there other locations?
The feldspar, The feldspar. Oh yeah, we have a pink quarry in the Laurentians in Canada. We have a black one in Pennsylvania.
Okay, so I knew that. This is from another person that was sharing this with me. I thought that there was a light gray and a dark gray.
You're correct. We have here in this pluton, we have the light one and the dark one. It's on the same pluton.
Yep.
But the dark one is over that way, man. I had a son pass away back in 1971.
Okay.
I worked at Wells Lamson's. They gave me the stone that is on, is a grass marker that I put on.
Okay.
Put in the cemetery.
Yeah.
The maintenance people broke the M out of his name.
Yes.
I went to them.
Yep.
And asked them what they were going to do. They said, well, we can replace that stone. I says, no, you can't replace that stone. That stone is irreplaceable.
Yes.
That stone came out of the Wells Lamson's quarry.
Yes.
It's all quarried out.
Okay, good. Okay. So
they said, well, we just turn it over.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Now, Hope Cemetery is a very prestigious cemetery.
Yeah.
But when I hollered at him, or when I went to him.
Right.
He said, what are you going to do about that stone?
Right.
And when I said, we're going to replace it, I said, I don't know where you're going to get that stone from.
You're not going to get it from. Yeah.
We'll turn it over. I said, well, whatever you do, but that stone, if you go touching that stone, it's irreplaceable.
It is. Yeah. And that's exactly when we find that situation, those are the very instance. You can't replace something, you can only tune it. You know,
yeah,
I work a lot with marble. A lot of what I work with. Because granite doesn't break unless you really mess it up, right? Marble degrades over time, it sugars away, you know, it's a lot softer of a material.
Yeah.
And so I don't have any issues with granite, really, unless something really severe happened.
Now, I've got stone that are on my parents' grave.
Yep.
And that come from Rock of Ages. Yep. It came from the dark side.
Sure.
I have a son-in-law that worked in a stone shed downtown.
Okay.
And when he helped me set that stone,
yeah,
he says to me, he says, where did you get this stone? He says, I haven't seen such clean stone in a long time. I says, it's where I work. Or, I worked
exactly.
at.
Exactly.
I worked
you
at.
You over there.
At Barre Quarry.
Right.
He said, "Man, I'd like to this stone."
Is it gone? Is it?
Actually, what happened is that it's on the granite, or when the granite came out or started solidifying.
Yeah.
It got into some slate. That's what makes it dark.
Yep.
And now the slates are great big pieces.
Yeah.
So it's more or less. That side of the quarry is sort of gone.
Yeah, yeah.
But they're trying to bring back to the Barre Quarry, we knew was dark.
So they're still
quarrying. They're still quarrying over
there.
We call it the dark side.
You call it the dark side, and who's the operator of that?
Rock of Ages.
Oh, you are? Okay,
yes,
okay,
yes.
Okay, 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 okay.
Okay.
There's different names. Okay,
yeah. That's what I tell people. When Rock of Ages bought all the other outlying quarries.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, now this is called the Smith Quarry.
Yeah.
The next quarry is called the Wetmore Quarry.
Okay.
The next quarry is called the Wells Lamson's Quarry. Then this way you got Rock of Ages, then the Adam Perry Quarry.
Yes. Yes.
And this is lighter.
Yes.
And grade.
Yes.
This is lighter.
Light. Yep.
Then that over there.
Yes. Yes. Okay. So.
We are at the E.L. Smith Quarry. It was started in the 1880s. Rock of Ages purchased it in the mid-1940s. Rock of Ages claims that the E.L. Smith Quarry is the world's deepest active granite quarry. It's 600 feet deep. Now, how we got in and out of the hole? Between the two derricks, there's a yellow cage-like. It looks like a cage. It's a man box. What we used to do, we used to get in that box. They pick us up, swing us out over the hole, and lower us to 600 feet to the bottom of the quarry. That ride took 15 minutes. 15 minutes down, 15 minutes back. They did that 4 times a day, 5 days a week. So that hour a day, we were being paid for it, but we weren't doing anything. And every time we made a pull with one of these derricks, we had to get back into a safe area. More downtime. So Rock of Ages developed what they call a drive-in quarry. You can see, like I said, you can see the rubber-tired vehicles all the way down. You look in the bottom of this pile here, you can see the vehicles can go right to the water's edge. Granite is an igneous stone, meaning it was molten, it was a magma. It was underneath the tectonic plates, and as the tectonic plates slipped and moved over one another, it created a chamber. We call that a pluton. This pluton is 2 miles wide, 4 miles long, and 10 miles deep. The geologists estimate we have about 4,500 years of granite to be taken out of this pluton at the rate we're taking out today. We have the three derricks, but this big yellow one is 160 foot high. It can lift 250 ton. The biggest stone that we ever took out with that stone, with that derrick, was 43 feet long, 8 foot high, and 6 foot wide. Granite weighs 180 pounds per cubic foot. So if you put that, if you work that formula out, that stone weighed 193 ton. We didn't take it off the bottom right after we put that derrick up. They quarried that stone out because they wanted to test that derrick, because they said it's 250 tons. So that 193 ton stone, they pulled out of the quarry. You see that water down there? It has a green tinge to it. It's caused by an algae bloom. The algae bloom, the iron in the stone, the sun, the chemical reactions and all that causes that water to be green. That's the water we use to flush our dust down. So what we do is we pump the water over to the where the men use it. The men use it, the water, they let the water come into the hole that's here. And this water color here, we call this colored water a glacier colored water. Now the only thing we've added to that is dust to the water. But we don't let this water get any deeper. We take this water and we pump it over to the middle pond. So you've got the three different shades of green here. Oh, let me see if I can stand in the way of the sun. Anyway, if you follow my finger, there's a gray streak in this stone. It's right here, it follows right here. That gray streak is an iron streak. Can you see it? If you look on the face of the stone, you can actually see it. It's not going straight down, it goes on an angle. So anyway, I showed you that I had the wedges and feathers. And what we do is that we take two feathers and a wedge, stick it in the hole. Every single one of these holes that you see in the stones all around here, every single one of these would have this set up in it. And what we'd do after you get it set up, what we would do is we take a 6 pound hammer and we wouldn't hit it hard. All we have to do is keep pressure on that. So you hit it, you wait for a while, you hit it again, because granite will break by pressure. On the MOHS scale, the Mohs scale of hardness, diamond is a 10, granite is a 7, marble is a 3. The difference between granite and marble. Granite is an igneous stone. Marble is a metamorphic stone, meaning marble was already a stone. Heat and pressure created marble. But they both break from the same principle. They both break by pressure. This stone weighs 54,000 pounds. If you were to convert that into tonnage, divide that figure by 2,000, this stone weighs 27 ton. How do we get this stone here? The machines that we have here, the rubber-tired vehicles, we have several 992B Caterpillars. They're rubber tired. They weigh 40 ton. They're supposed to be able to lift their own weight. So this stone weighing 27 ton, that 992B wouldn't have any problem moving this stone.